this day. Because as our Lord Jesus Christ entered triumphantly into Jerusalem, before he got to Jerusalem, when he was on Mount Olives, something happened. That is big lesson for all of us. As he got on Mount Olives, the high mountain, and from there you can see the panoramic view of Jerusalem. He saw Jerusalem and he wept. He knew the destruction that would come over Jerusalem in 2 years' time. And he went. Let me ask you one question. If our Lord Jesus Christ will enter this house of prayer now and look at all, will he weep or will he be happy? If you look at us, infighting, quarreling, hatred, jealousy, he's going to weep. That should not be in our midst. For the past 32 days, that's all I've been talking. Let us back away from our midst, name of Jesus. You know, we say in Demuren, Seraphim, Jesus is what the head of Seraphim. Jesus Christ owned this Seraphim. And he gave us a lot of spiritual power. Our in 1:204, verse 4, he said, Jesus has proclaimed us as light of the world to cast away all darkness. The city that beat on the hill can never be hidden. Jesus has made us the salt of the world to greatly sweeten the heart. If the salt has stopped its flavor, how can we make it sweet? That's the challenge between you and me today. That's what Lord Jesus has done. If Jesus had to enter into Jerusalem's land, into our various acts of prayer, that's what we expect to see. But what have we come the church into? Are we showing the light of the world? Are we the salt of the earth? My brother and sister, we need to look at this and change our life. Also, I will repeat again, I mention this every time I preach now, because the kingdom of God is the word of all Christians. Lord Jesus gave his condition. He said to Peter, to enter the kingdom of God, I'm going to ask you this question. You must answer me. I was hungry, did you give me food? I was thirsty, did you give me drink? I was a stranger, did you give me a place to stay? I was naked, did you give me dress to wear? When I was sick, did you come to visit me? I was in prison. Did you minister to me? If you have not done this, then you can't enter the kingdom of God. Our prayer is that God will change our lives. Yes. We will love each other. Yes. We will allow God to meet and all those things that make us good. And God will remove them all. Yes. And bind us together because of God. Yes. That's our prayer. And then, you know, I still must mention this to you. From last Sunday, you know, normally we fill up all the text that we saw from Sunday morning to this time. If Lord Jesus enter this house of prayer now, and as for Sunday, Mama preached, he preached on drunkenness, overfeeding, suffering, banqueting, care of life. Some of us, I didn't say, want to repeat so much, like feed. They gave, I don't know how much I'm used to carry the dough. They gave hope to some small sister, they said they want to start party upon party. Shall we talk? That's the problem. Say on Monday talk about pride. And pride goes for destruction. And Lord Jesus said, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and I'll exalt you in due course. Tuesday talk about faithfulness and honesty. Honesty and weakness. What does that mean? This we need to bring back. Wednesday, stubbornness. Some of us are just like double goals. We can't do nothing. We can't obey any instruction. You must do contrary so that you are this. Marriage is of all kind. Some of our men and women are just like going to school. Any guy can say that thing. The sin of not fearing God, that was on Friday. You want to all see, summarize everything that we have. And last of it, yesterday, that's not what that means in that. You know, I learned something what he said. He And some don't pay at all. And those who pay, don't pay correct. What you tell yourself? She read it from another, not in this fashion, from another Bible, from another fashion. So it's very clear to understand. All of us have committed this sin. God will forgive all our sins. He will never be able to sin no more. So this blessing will go around all of us. And my brother and sister in law, it's not finished yet. The prince started. Now he's going to Jerusalem. He entered an orphan. And I pray that you enter into our hearts. Enter into our homes. Enter into our churches. Enter into our family. Enter into our country, Nigeria. And take our life for good. He cleansed the temple when he got there, as I said. Because there is something we need to remind ourselves. That the major problem now in all the churches of this world, particularly those in Nigeria, God's full of prosperity, but God's full of salvation. By throwing out the paper of the overturning the papers of the money changers and saying that my if the house of God, my house will be a house of prayer, don't turn the gate of Jesus.